Cure. I'm Dan Tompkins. I'm the science director at Predator-Free 2050 Limited. And one of the things we've done at the company is to run a round of capability development investments and grants for students and postdocs. Now we're doing this because PF2050, the Predator-Free 2050 mission, is going to take new ways of doing things. It's going to take new tools and new approaches. But to get there, we need the new young blood, the new ideas in at the beginning. And so what we've been doing is we've been giving money for PhDs and postdocs, young scientists early in their career, to let them start to focus on issues for PF2050. But also as well, we're not being too top-down telling them what to do. This is money for them to have their own ideas to bring to the party. And so we're really hopeful that in the next 2 to 3 years, some of the advances that they're making will help our landscape projects on the ground do a better job of eradicating possums, rats and stoats. And this is why we've invited the students and postdocs along to our landscape project, HUI. This is a great opportunity for them to talk with the people on the ground, to hear more about what the problems are, and also for the landscape projects to hear about what the students are doing and how it might help them to achieve what they want to achieve in the years to come. Elana Alexander is a postdoc at University of Otago.
A koao koao tetahi uri o te hikatū ki roto I te whare tapu o Ngāpui me Pākehā ko Elana Alexander tō kuingoa. I'm a kaimahi, a research fellow down here at the University of Otago where I look at possums in hybrid zones. Possums in New Zealand come from, are thought to have come from two major sources, Victoria in the mainland of Australia and Tasmania. So they, when they got here, they've become a bit of a hodgepodge, a mix of these two different subspecies. And when these hodgepodges, these hybrid zones set up, some genes can make it across the hybrid zone, ones that are really important for things like maybe resistance to toxins, while some get trapped on each side. And the ones that get trapped on each side, we think are more important for things like reproduction and survival. So you can think about a horse and a donkey, when they interbreed, they make a mule. That mule itself is sterile, so the genes kind of can't make it out of that mule. And that, those are the ones that we're talking about that might be important for reproduction and survival. One of the ways I think this research can be used for Predator-Free 2050 Limited's goal is because novel ways of knocking down predators and suppressing them and removing them from the landscape are really important. They seem to be able to become accustomed to some of the methods that we're already using, so having new things that we can consistently bring into the effort's really important. So it's been a really awesome platform for me to give back to the conservation community by developing and applying genetics to an actual conservation question of really real great importance. It's also allowed me to show that I am capable of getting independent funding, because that's a real tohu in the academic world of success as a scientist.
Ali Palmer is a postdoc at University of Auckland.
So I'm an anthropologist by training. And my research really focuses on contentious social issues in conservation. Just trying to figure out what different sides think about predator-free, what issues might come up for them, and essentially whether there's any way that we can proactively find a way to resolve any conflicts that might come up essentially before they arise. So the way that it could impact Predator-Free 2050 is massive actually. Like, I mean, as we've been hearing at the HUI today, for almost every project, the biggest issue has been just making sure the community's on board, because essentially nothing can happen, arguably maybe even nothing should happen, unless the community is behind a project, right? So my project is really going directly to that. It's trying to figure out what is it that the community wants here, what is it that people might object to, and how can we make sure that the way that Predator-Free 2050 is done is in line with all that.
Brittany Graham is a PhD student at Lincoln University.
So the aim of my research is to ultimately create a lure that plays on the different senses of the possum. So we are testing audio, visual and also scent. Over the past year, since my research has begun, I have been doing a few pen trials, a few field trials, testing out the different lures and seeing how the possums are reacting to them. The coolest thing that has happened to me throughout this whole capability development funding is actually being able to network and being able to come in contact with people who are like-minded. We've actually almost created an audio lure like product that is really light, really easy to use, and potentially quite cost-friendly. So hopefully we'll be able to get those out at some point to community groups, to landowners, to be able to help do small steps to improve and reach that 2050 goal.
Ben McEwen is a PhD student at University of Canterbury.
My research is related to bioacoustic monitoring of invasive predator species and lure selection. just using food-based lures and food-based trapping isn't going to be sufficient for total elimination. So we need better detection tools, we need better luring tools. So where my research fits in with that is bioacoustic monitoring and detection. So a key aspect of my research is the collection of audio data, and that's a real challenge. We collect over 100 hours of recordings each week, and roughly 0.4% of that actually contains features that we're interested in. So it always takes a massive amount of time to analyse that data. So over the last year, we've been developing an annotation tool which automatically scans through all that data, extracts features of interest, and presents that to a user. So the aim here is to develop a classification pipeline for use out in the field. So Predator-Free 2050 Limited has funded my research, and it's also helped along the way with supporting me with different connections and resources.